you're seeing such a move away from that. It's like, if we keep going, like, where do we go from there? You hear me? Does everything then become, like, the opposite? You know?
I think so. I feel like, but I feel like we're going, it's all, you know, going back to how it was.
Yeah, time just...
It's a loop. So we're here at the airport, super early for a change. This is very new for us. And we decided to get breakfast at this little spot called Bisu.
Hungry.
So we got a breakfast sandwich. You know, wherever we go, it's a bacon, egg, and cheese. You already know. This is on a brioche bun, though. And then they got the ketchup on the side. Y'all know what it is. We made it to Atlanta. The weather is not that great. It is rainy and 48 degrees. I did not expect that at all. It's not that bad compared to New York, obviously, but I still would like it to be warmer. It's crazy because when we check the weather, it says that it's gonna be warmer when we leave. Like, literally the day we leave, it's gonna get warmer. Annoying. But hopefully while we're here, the weather kind of changes and warms up a little bit more. Yeah, right now we're just getting the rental and gonna head to the hotel. Probably chill for a while. And then we have some massage appointments, which I'm so excited about. I haven't gotten massages in a long time, so it's way overdue. That's the update for now. I'll obviously check back in maybe later in the day when we're about to go for dinner. Yeah, besides that, see ya. Hotel room and I am gobsmacked. I feel like that's gonna be my word when I review hotel rooms. This is the Hotel Midtown in Atlanta. It's a boutique style hotel based on a collection by the Hilton, and it's really gorgeous. Like, you walk in and you feel like you're stepping into luxury. You feel like everything's like super high end. And also feels like modern and contemporary. So I really, really love it. This is definitely on my speed. And, you know, if you've been around to this channel before, then you've seen the type of hotels that we usually go to. And this is definitely on that level. The room is super clean. Well, I did want to say, like, the first room that we got, we walked in and it, like, stunk of cigarette smoke. I don't know why. But fortunately, they were able to give us another room on a higher floor. So I'm, like, super grateful for that. Same layout and everything, but it's just like, I didn't actually walk into the first one, not too far, so I didn't really see that much, but it seemed like the same layout. And I'm super impressed. that I will definitely say I am super impressed by the decor, the detailing of everything. Everything just seems very unique and like slight hints of vintage thrown in there. So I really, really love that element. So it's kind of like giving mid-century modern type of vibe, which is definitely my vibe in terms of like home decor and stuff like that. So yeah, I'm really excited. Ooh, combo special massage. What area is this actually?
It's like Brookhaven. It's called Brookhaven.
Brookhaven.
It's a lemon pound cake.
Why would you never see this in New York?
I've never seen it at all.
No, not at Or Whole Foods though. It is very much different everywhere. Hey y'all. Good morning. Good morning, good morning, good morning. It is a beautiful Monday morning. It's a little bit warmer than yesterday. I don't want to say because the sun is bright and out today, but we'll see as it goes on throughout the day. It's supposed to go up to like a 60, so I'm really happy. I have my outfit because we are doing a lot of wedding things today. So I'm gonna go to my first dress appointment here in Atlanta. And then after that, we're gonna go on a bunch of venue tours. So that's gonna be fun to see as well. So I'm gonna take you guys along with me on that. Right now, we're just getting coffee. We stopped to get a little breakfast. But yeah, I'm super excited about today. Today's gonna be a great day. Hopefully I can find a dress that's similar to the one that I previously loved in New York. If not, we'll just see what happens. Making it my way to my first bridal appointment. Right now we're at Bridals by Amy. There we go. So I am here. I made it. I'm at Bridals by Amy. And how gorgeous is this place? Like, oh, I'm so excited. This is today's outfit. Ooh, the lighting. I went with all white because we're doing bridal stuff today, so all white.
You're not gonna love me, but you can't film in here.
Oh, I'm so sorry. So we are at our first venue appointment of the day. And how amazing does it look already? Super excited. A little update from that first wedding appointment, that bridal appointment, did not go well, y'all. I couldn't film, I couldn't take no pictures, hey, so I don't even remember what the dresses are looking like. Hi!
And a lot of times, you've got on nice shoes, so we won't get on that. It's probably squishy from the rain.
Oh, got it. Muddy.
Usually, when people use this, they have their chairs facing this way.
Okay.
And their minister or their officiant is right there.
Right,
you know,
here.
So the bride can make her entrance. I've seen them come from out of the double doors and down this way. I've also seen her father or the person escorting her pick her up on a cart.
Cart and bring her around.
And drive her to here or here. You know, so it just depends on what you want to do. But usually,
yeah,
all the chairs would be facing this way.
Okay.
But do we have to hire our own setup and takedown crew?
And everything is white and glass is supposed to be. So if you have chosen something different, once they're set,
but our crew will set up the tables, have the, if you want to play dinner, they'll have the appropriate plates and
gonna
cups
say.
And all the tin forks and things there. And it'll be set for that and it'll already have.
Hi, this is President Nichelle speaking. I wanted to pop in and give you guys an overview of what actually happened on our trip to Atlanta. We were only there for 2 days, and between those 2 days, we had a jam-packed schedule between bridal appointments and wedding venue tours. So overall, we honestly didn't really find what we were looking for. I went to multiple bridal appointments and did not really like the dresses. I couldn't record or my battery died. I did though take some pictures, and with our wedding venues, one really stood out, but overall there was none that was actually within the budget that we had allocated for the venue and had all the little things that we were looking for. So after that experience, we went back to New York, and ultimately I decided to hit up a Jamaican designer that I know to make a custom wedding dress. And although I had fell in love with the dress in New York, it ultimately was way out of the budget, and it actually worked out reaching out to this friend because I was able to get two dresses for the price of that one dress in New York. So ultimately, I'm happy that I made that decision. Anyway, back to the episode.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is MelaninBanc, aka Nichelle. I'm checking in. I actually woke up in a different city this morning. I actually flew down to Miami to do my dress fittings because I'm getting married. So I did my dress fittings earlier. Y'all haven't seen it yet, but I will give you a few little sneak peeks so you can, you know, get excited as I am. I'm so happy. Like, I miss Miami so much. I love Miami so much. So we're staying at the Mondrian South Beach, and it is a one bedroom suite. This is a little kitchenette area, which is really fun because we have microwave, which is always comes in handy, actually, when you're traveling, always comes in handy. We got a mini fridge filled with lots of good stuff, an actual stove, hot stove. So that's great. A little dining area. So much space. A whole living room area. This is so much space. Check out the views. Just great views, great views. Then we go to the bedroom. Oh, crap. Actually, miss, we have a whole powder room, powder bathroom. Hey, y'all. That's the powder room. Then we go into the bedroom. And it, once again, so much space, so huge. We have a TV. All of these are closets, so much space for storage. And then the actual bathroom, which also has a chandelier. I'm obsessed. I love the backsplash of this bath, of the shower. So pretty. And then our bathroom. Hi. Yes. So that is the little tour.
Burger topped with a flaming hot Cheetos, crusted pepper jack cheese. That's nuts.
I was like, what is this? Whipped cream?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Like a sauce with a chicken. Yeah, help yourself. She's not gonna eat all of that. You got this big burger. You gotta get it.
Y'all better eat too.
That's good.
I was just about to say that. That's exactly what that is.
That's
huge. Yeah.
butter. It's kind of like a butter. Yeah. Butter sauce.
All you characters, you're like a fire in a small field room. So breathe it in just like the flames of the two. You got a heart and body burning blue.
Got a whole hash brown, bacon, sausage.
Cut you a piece. Change for some chicken.
That's black hole, I think.
Yeah.
Really?
I think so.
Yeah, those are super.
Every hour spot is back by the hotel.
But what time is their happy hour though?
6 to 8.
Yes, that's happy. Is there no happy hour?
Let's see. 17 minutes away from the Oasis now.
Oh, there's a timeout marking.
Yeah, just like in New York.
Oh, yeah, I
saw that earlier, but I was like, maybe during the week we'll do that or something. You know? Because it was so far up north, I was like, ain't too much stuff up north. You know, it's going to last so myself.
The boat party? You know, we got
you know, I saw some of those, but I was like, nah, next time.
Man.
Sandwich boat party, open bar, you know they got the strippers on here.
Okay.
See, they got them all. Thank you.
Oh, wow. Are you excited?
Some chicken. Oh, that's going to be good.
Yeah. Let's dig in.
Like a bendy or a milkshake.
Yeah, the
cherry
straws, right?
Like, what should we pack? They want
the extendo.
It's good. I like the taste.
It's really tasty. Mm-hmm. I can say this. For the amount of alcohol that's in there, you don't really taste it.
That's crazy.
Oh my gosh. Oh. Oh. You know, thank you for the bird.
Oh, no, no, thank you.
They're really interested in how, like, how ancient people vacation, like how they, you know what I mean?
How old?
Like, how they vacation? How did they vacation?
Every day is a vacation. I don't think, you know what is what's funny? Like, they really didn't even have a concept of vacation, you know?
That looks so good.
Thank you. It's good.
Yeah. Yeah, what if I did never really say vacation, but like obviously make sure to take time away from, because obviously work was not life as it is now.
Yeah, the concept of everything was different.
Yeah.
You know what's so funny? Like, they had learned that, like, even the concept of slaves, like, they say, like, slaves built pyramids or whatnot. Like, they had healthcare, they had a
pension,
and it was like, all the modern things that we think are so modern, they, like,
they had
it, yeah. You know what I mean?
It wasn't slavery as we know.
Yeah. It was like being in servitude or in service, like being a service worker, you know what I mean?
Exactly.
So a lot of those work, even like, what's the word they used to describe black people back then? This is not bronze, but
brunette.
Like, even the words, some of the things don't translate to, like, now, you know what I mean?
Not at all. Imagine if
but
they
that's
were
how they play with it,
now.
Yeah. Does it mean something different now? It means a brown hair colored girl.
Okay.
I'm so old, man. See a lot of different stuff everywhere now, you know? Yeah, I feel like generations is out today, you know? That's so funny because you always see so many black couples in
Miami. That's what I was going to say too, and I feel like this is one of the first times that we've seen so many, you know?
How y'all doing?
Doing good,
I see you guys smiling. You guys having a good old conversation here with the band, right? Mm-hmm. That's what's up, being a little lady. My name is Richard. Nice to meet you guys. Where you guys from?
New York. Yep. It's our last day, so we will have any itinerary left to do much more.
I appreciate it.
That's cool. We're up in Harlem.
Harlem. I've been to Harlem a couple times. I went down Rob one time. You feel me? I took the wrong train. That was the problem. I took the wrong train. So that happened like the first year I was up there, you know, so I was staying in Long Island.
Okay.
After a lot of partying and stuff in Manhattan.
Okay.
Freaking trying to get back to this train. So I was trying to get to my sister's house in Brooklyn. Right?
Okay.
Because, you know, the Long Island railroad. I'm trying to get to my sister's, but she's not taking the wrong train.
Oh, man!
Like 4 in the morning.
Oh, my God. Wrong time you
want to
be out.
Have a good one.
like to make the best way to make that bad. So going with Southern Styles podcast,
really?
When he actually got robbed at home.
Really?
The funny thing is, I feel like he was playing chess at a park. I don't know if it was at our park, but he was like, got robbed.
I mean, like, you don't want to be in the park at night in general, like.
Yeah, you just gotta watch what you do and where you go. Yeah, man.
I'm like, I haven't been in Tyler for long. Never.
Calamari?
Yes.
Calamari.
Ooh, that looks great, bro.
That looks so good. Ooh, thank you. Can we have two small plates?
Okay.
Yes. Thank you. Look at the jumbo shrimp. Jumbo shrimp is so good.
I got you. I'll hook it up. Don't worry about it.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's the secret about you.
Wait, no, can you put it right here? Can you lift
like
it?
Middle. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay. Okay. Still, you can always eat and then go back to drinking.
Exactly.
Never go wrong with fried calamari. They look good.
Hello. It's me again. It's Sunday. Happy Sunday. Happy Father's Day. Happy Juneteenth. So much is happening today. I'm actually in Chicago at the moment at my parents-in-law's house, and we're actually gonna do a little engagement party with this side of the family, so it's gonna be nice. So we actually just finished setting everything up, pretty much everything up, and food is cooking. We got ribs, we got corn, we got mac and cheese, we got potato salad. Like, we throwing it down. We about to eat good. And yeah, so I'm gonna take you guys around, show y'all around the space, and this is what we're working with. So the hot food, of course, is gonna go in here. But this is where we set up the tables and stuff. I love these little bows on the back. Our little sweetheart table over here. Got these cupcakes at Sam's Club because they do have really delicious cupcakes and cakes and all that jazz. So definitely had to get some from Sam's Club. And that's pretty much it. That's the vibe for today. This is a family affair, so it's gonna be a fun time. So let me tell you what's going on right here. We got grilled corn, ribs, and sausage. You see those ribs? My baby did those ribs. He did all the grilling, actually. So, you know, we got potatoes, we got stuffing. What else we got? We got baked beans. Oh. And we also got some greens. You can see them on camera because it's we got green. And then the mac and cheese is in the oven. Oh, the mac and cheese. We also got turkey in here that's just done too. We got a lot of food, so I am excited. That's our first guest.
Is the second option.
So I made it, you guys. I'm outside my bridal shower.
I'm telling you,